All right, we are back here. This is gonna be our probably the final video for Saturday, July 3rd here. So this might be the our wrap up, what we call the wrap up video of the day. You know, but then again, it might not be. I might end up doing videos myself at home. So
do I have to say hello to my mom?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, mom. I wanted to say that. It's my mom's birthday today, so.
And Reggie, man, what's up, man? You know, and you know, you can't hear us watching this right now, but you know, we know you receive the energy. We were with you earlier.
Send you good vibes, brother.
Yeah, you know, and people who knew Reggie, man, you know, I mean, you gotta drop him a line, man. You know, a friend of mine is locked up. I have several friends locked up right now that I know. You know, we're talking about ways. We're going to talk about. I got a lot of ideas. We're going to do a good video. It started at 8:22 last month. We got 20 minutes for video. But I'm talking about, like, my ideas about loving all people. A little while ago, I regret we didn't get it on tape now. But we were using our minds to just checking out in jails in Richmond. You know, remote viewing and just.
Yeah.
You know, it was basically like you see people with the astral body, but we were out here and there, just like we do with the portal across the people over, except we're cruising around jails, checking out what's going on and sending people different types of vibrational energies.
Right.
You know, all positive, but different shades, different hues, different types, depending on the situation, you know. But then Jeremy, I told Jeremy to tune. I started out doing the loon first, thinking about him going to jail and stuff. And next thing I know, I'm there, cruising around, checking out different day rooms and seeing what people are doing, watching card games go on. I just sat there, watched the game. Then Jeremy jumped in. He was seeing the exact same thing I was. I didn't have to describe anything. I see it all. He was describing what I saw. I could see exactly what he saw.
Yeah,
to
cool.
the to that to that what was the detail?
Yeah, I could see a guy like fussing and shit. He was like,
sitting at a little table at
yeah.
the bench, yeah.
Fuss dreaming, yeah. I don't know.
TV up loud, echoing in the halls,
Yeah.
you know, and every little detail. We can even feel the warmth coming in from the sun in the window.
Oh yeah.
And you know,
I can see the bricks on the wall, like the little lines in between or anything, yeah.
every little detail.
Yeah.
But it comes down to, like, we were trying to love the people. We were talking about that yesterday, that people locked up need love too, because we've
Yeah.
been there. You
Yeah, they
know,
need love.
believe me, we've been there. I've been there. He's
Yeah.
been there. A lot of, you know, we know, you know. Trust me, it's not a good feeling, you know.
You don't want to be in jail, and you don't want
Not the feeling of abandoned. People locked up in prison and jail. Prison's especially doing a lot. I was doing a
Speaking
lot
with
of
your brother.
time.
Speaking with your brother. Tell him how
They need love. You know, you need to just say, you don't have to be there even. If you can empower your mind with true belief and knowledge, spiritual knowledge, you can be there remotely. You can just see shining light coming out of you and know what's going out into people and into buildings themselves. You can implant people if you want. You can even just put a little bit of your vibe in people, like giving them a pill, and then it'll come out at the right time for them. Automatically, they'll receive that dose of happiness. You can give it when you want to, you know. But we were out with Reggie up at, I think he had Pamunkey Jail, Pamunkey Regional Jail, slightly, telepathically and remotely. And a lot of that, there's a lot of, we were doing that. We could feel the feeling empathically, too. Let me say that. I was there, we were feeling the feelings, seeing the sights, and energizing you people through bodies, you know,
Yeah.
that I felt that, you know. Jails have conflicting energy. People are angry, confused, happy, mentally ill, off. It's, you know, we were looking at the deputies in there, watching what they were doing.
Like you said, abandoned. They feel abandoned.
Abandoned mostly. And that's what Reg was feeling, abandoned and stupid and angry, you know.
Yeah.
And it's all the shit. You feel it all at the same time, so you know.
That'd be in there.
So, yeah, like, I even started, like, we were taking a break, and then I started writing a letter to Reggie, because I had a note down that I needed to write him a letter anyway, you know, and then I made sure I started it so I knew that it would be done.
Yeah,
but
try to keep it real, you know.
Yeah, I want to, because I've known him so long, man. I know his whole family, so he's a lot younger than me, but so many people are getting in trouble, man. Like, I'm there again. All right, as we taught now, I'm back.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. It just happened by itself. It's been going on as I've been talking here. I'm there. I'm here and there. I'm looking around. I'm feeling the energy again. But it's heavy. It's going to be some heavy energy. But this is the kind of thing we're trying to teach y'all to do, is use your minds to help people this way. Help people, you see, in your minds, you know, remotely, that your relatives, your friends, why don't you call your friends up in your mind? Think of it like this. Let me give you a meditation you could do that can turn into a far more than a meditation. You know, picture like a friend that you love, and then like go into your mind and feel that love. You know, find a friend and then like see all the faults and the arguments you might have with that person, or you know, and the good times, and then go think about all of it at the same time, and just use your mind, just knowing that it's all good. Basically, look at it like that. Know that it's all good, and love that person. And then before you know it, you'll be blessed with the ability to do more than one person. You got to start out somewhere. So start out loving one person compassionately, without judgment, you know, when you do that, the sexual love is going to disappear automatically. Any kind of attraction to someone's body is going to go. You know, it's a very satisfying feeling when that happens. When you know that you're loving people way past a physical attraction, and there's not even anything involved like that.
Yeah, yeah.
That's such a great feeling, because it's so euphoric. You know, it's a...
People in general, you know.
People in general, everybody. You know, we don't want to leave anyone out. You know, you've seen the videos where we talk about that people who kill people in jail or not in jail need love and compassion, even people doing bad things, whatever you consider to be bad in this world, I guess. You know, they need love. You know, not just the so-called good people in this world, in this society. You gotta love it all. It's a prerequisite of spiritual enlightenment, you know. True enlightenment is when you love everybody like that, everything, you know, from the heart, from the soul. I feel like it's hard to describe in words, but
no, it's good.
I speak up. I've been doing a lot of talking here, but I just had it on my mind.
You did good talking, you know. I mean, what you're saying is beautiful stuff, man. You know, like, you know, I think that, negative on, you know.
Turn it into positive.
Turn it into a positive. You know,
help without letting it bring you down.
Like, help us help you, you know. You know, kind of thing, you know.
Yeah, it's...
I mean, this is what you said was so interesting, you know. It's not like I don't have anything to say.
Do you want me to talk some more?
Yeah, I mean, go ahead.
Let me see if I can... So, I'm going to talk from the heart and talk about whatever comes to mind spiritually.
Yeah.
Let me see how about that? Do you think that would work for them?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, let me just talk about, because I do this sometimes. Sometimes I just feel words coming out of me and feelings, and I just got to express, you know, like I feel on the verge of that. I'm not all the way there. It might take me a second to warm up, but we've got about 12 minutes left. We've got plenty of time.
Right.
But, I mean, this thing about, you know, loving everybody, it's real important. It can't be ignored. You got to love his mother. It can't be ignored. You know, you just got to do it, you know. You got to, you know, because, you know, once you get to that state, it's not just because you're trying to reach a euphoric state. It's because, like, you really do care about everybody,
yeah.
You know. Like, now that euphoric state is, like, something that comes with the territory. You know, it's going to come and happen.
Like the award.